Garnock Connections is a landscape partnership scheme working to protect and enhance the natural and cultural heritage around the River Garnock. Garnock Connections is primarily funded by the National Lottery Heritage Fund, with many aspects of the 25 interconnecting projects benefiting from the Green Infrastructure Community Engagement Fund. The project area follows the River Garnock from the Clyde Muirshield Hills in the north, down through parts of Renfrewshire and North Ayrshire, where it meets the River Irvine to form a double estuary at Irvine Harbour. Garnock Connections was driven by local people, communities and organisations who demonstrated a passion and demand for landscape-scale action to conserve and enhance natural and cultural heritage, leaving a legacy of benefits stretching long into the future. The project helped reconnect the communities of Lochwinnock, Beath, Dalry, Kilwinning, the three towns and Irvine with their heritage by providing opportunities to develop skills and improve health and well-being through increased activity in local green spaces. Our mission has been to connect people and places within the landscape. We have achieved this via four main networks: habitats, access, knowledge, and community. Since the project began, we have funded four trainee posts. Two of these were wildlife recording assistants, who have delivered a series of wildlife recording workshops and provided training to both the public and volunteer groups. These events and workshops have proved very popular and have been successfully delivered both face-to-face and virtually. Furthermore, we've had two volunteer engagement assistants who have supported volunteer groups by advertising events, sourcing and purchasing equipment, and creating an online volunteer hub. Through this, the trainees have gained various transferable skills and experience. One of our trainees also created four school workbooks and lesson plans. The workbooks can be used by children either at home or at school, with the aim of helping them learn about wildlife and conservation in the form of fun educational activities. We have delivered a variety of wildlife recording training events and workshops, many led by our trainees, to give local people the skills to survey and help protect their local wildlife. Overall, we have engaged with 223 event participants across the Garnock Connections landscape, on topics ranging from amphibians and reptiles to tree identification. Pre-pandemic, we delivered many small face-to-face workshops. But since adapting to delivering online workshops, we have been able to welcome even more participants. While nothing beats the feeling of being out on a site, moving our events online has enabled larger and more varied audiences to access them. We have a library of recording equipment and a school pack, all free for community groups, individuals and schools to borrow. Before moving to remote working, the Garnock Connections recording equipment was being used regularly by people across the landscape, with 104 loans. The availability of free-to-borrow recording equipment has allowed event participants to practice wildlife recording and build on the knowledge gained from training events. One volunteer even captured this image of a badger using one of the Garnock Connections wildlife cameras. As well as learning how to identify wildlife and how to use recording equipment, event participants have been learning how to use iRecord to record their wildlife sightings. The setup of the Garnock Connections iRecord activity and community engagement have contributed to the development of a more robust database of wildlife across the Garnock Connections landscape. So far, 7,083 records have been made by 145 recorders. Wildlife records across the landscape have dramatically increased since Garnock Connections began in 2018. As has the spread of recorded sites. At events across the landscape, we gathered stories about local heritage and favourite trails from local people, which helped shape our access plan and our Heritage Trails app, Places That We Know. Garnock Connections encouraged and supported local people to add 27 trails to the app, highlighting key natural and cultural points along the way, and that doesn't even include the ones still to be published. The app inspired people to create their own trails or simply gave them the confidence to discover someone else's. This has helped promote a sense of pride in the landscape and what it has to offer locals and visitors alike. Interestingly, many of the trails correspond to areas which have seen increased wildlife recording. Some of these trails lead local trailblazers to visit habitat improvement projects that have been carried out by local groups and can be found dotted around the project area. Among these are the new wetlands created at Giffin Mill Meadow and Bar Mill, created in partnership with the Bar Mill Conservation Group. The new ponds have improved habitat for a variety of birds, invertebrates and other wildlife, especially waders and wildfowl such as snipe. The group already have plans to add dipping platforms, which will help more local people discover and share the meadow's wildlife. Another major habitat improvement project was to create 6 hectares of new community woodland, which involved planting an impressive 6,000 native trees at 2 main sites. The first of these was at Ardeer Quarry Local Nature Reserve, previously a site of poorly maintained lawn, which now provides access to a more diverse urban habitat for people to enjoy. The second site was at Groat Home near Dalry, where an access route was created, as well as a new woodland with new fencing protecting the young trees from livestock and deer. These new woodlands were planted by volunteers and trainees and will be managed into the future by local community groups. Both of these sites will help to improve local resilience to flooding and climate change. The last community habitat improvement project, also helping to improve local resilience to flooding and climate change by reducing coastal erosions, was the restoration of 1,400 square metres of sand dunes at Stevenson Beach. This was achieved by installing chestnut fencing to encourage new dune formation. Young fir dunes are a rare habitat for southwest Scotland, and rare habitats encourage rare species who establish their homes here. Popular with local people for recreation, restoring these dunes and engaging locals in their importance will help safeguard the habitat and species recorded through identification workshops and activities. Another project that supported habitats for wildlife was the creation of 5 hectares of species-rich grassland meadows in areas of Kilburnie, Loch Shore and Ardrossan. The creation of these new habitats, that will hopefully soon look like this, has also encouraged ongoing training and workshops introducing more people to pollinators and wildflowers. This has provided people with more support, encouragement and opportunity to develop identification skills and increase their confidence to submit records to our iRecord activity. The addition of a volunteer hub to the Garnock Connections website now allows existing and prospective volunteers to find ways to get involved in projects across the landscape. Here, volunteers can find information about upcoming opportunities and can get in touch with community groups in their local area. They can also browse a range of citizen science surveys run by conservation organisations, from mammal monitoring with the Mammal Society to bumblebee transects with the Bumblebee Conservation Trust. Volunteers can find a survey that suits them. If volunteers need any hints or tips, they can find identification guides and links to organisation websites in the website resources. The Volunteer Hub was created with a purpose of bringing volunteer groups and members of the public within the landscape together. To that end, we have also created a Facebook group, which currently has 94 members, with posts being added regularly. Thank you to all our partners, local communities across the landscape, and the Green Infrastructure Community Engagement Fund who supported these amazing projects. Local people have been equipped with new skills and knowledge to protect and enhance their local heritage and have engaged with new tools and a suite of integrated activities to actively engage with and access green infrastructure. This has helped develop a newfound confidence to explore and discover the landscape which is important to them. We have been equally inspired and are confident that these projects are safe in the hands of people who will participate in the active management and conservation of the landscape far into the future. For the benefit of the people, wildlife, and green infrastructure of the Garnock Connections area.